Hi guys, welcome back to today's video. It's almost been a year since we published the teardown video of Apple's first 140W GaN charger. You can also click the upper right corner to see if you haven't. But it seems like we forget to test its actual charging performance, and many people are requesting this. So today we're gonna do a detailed charging review video for this charger. I think everyone should be familiar with this charger now. Let's briefly introduce it. It adopts the same design as the Apple 96W charger, but a little bit longer and larger than 96W. The input plug is foldable and detachable. It's only equipped with a white USB-C port. The specs info is printed on the side, model is A2452. It supports input of 120V, 50 or 60Hz, 2A, and the output of 5V, 3A, 9V, 3A, 15V, 5A, 20.5V, 5A, 28V, 5A. The manufacturer is Flectronics Power. And the size of this charger is about 96x75x28mm, so the power density is about 0.67 watts cubic centimeter. Weight is about 276 grams. And the Power ZKM002C shows it can support PD 3.1 protocol. It also supports 5 fixed PDOs, and the maximum output power is 140 watts. As for the charging compatibility test, you can also click the upper right corner to check our previous video. In general, since it can only support the PD protocol, it's designed for PD devices. The charging speed of some Android phones like Samsung is also less than 20 watts because it cannot support PPS protocol. Also, keep in mind that it cannot support 12V PDO. And then let's use this charger to fully charge the 16-inch MacBook Pro. The voltage is pretty stable at 28 volts, and the maximum charging power is about 129 watts at 25 minutes. After that, the current gradually drops to almost 0.2 amp. It takes an hour and 49 minutes to be fully charged. We also draw it into the curve. This 140 watts power adapter can charge the MacBook up to 56% in half an hour, the same as Apple claims. And it also reaches 87% in an hour and 100% in an hour and 49 minutes. As for the standby power part, the no-load power consumption of the charger at 220 volts 50Hz is 0.162 watts, which is about 1.419 kWh in 1 year. And the no-load power consumption at 110 volts 60Hz is 0.113 watts. Which is about 0.989 kWh in 1 year. In the conversion efficiency test, the conversion efficiency varies from 87.41% to 93.34% at 220 volts 50Hz. The conversion efficiency varies from 88.95% to 93.48% at 110 volts 60Hz. It can reach more than 90%, which is excellent among PD chargers. Next, let's test its ripple. The lower ripple means better quality. Firstly, let's see the 220 volts 50Hz. When the output is 9 volts 0 amp, the highest ripple is 184 millivolts peak to peak. When the output is 5 volts 2 amp, the lowest ripple is 20 millivolts peak to peak. Then switch to the 110 volts 60Hz. The results are almost the same. When the output is 9 volts 0 amp, the highest ripple is 184 millivolts peak to peak. When the output is 5 volts 2 amp, the lowest ripple is 20 millivolts peak to peak. And then we put it into a 25 degrees Celsius thermal tank throughout the test and let it run for an hour. And firstly, the maximum temperature on two sides are 52.5 degrees Celsius and 55 degrees Celsius under 220 volts 50Hz. Then the maximum temperature on two sides is 56 degrees Celsius and 56.3 degrees Celsius under 110 volts 60Hz. It feels warm but not hot. We also tested the full load performance of this charger. We adjusted the charger to 28V 5A 140W and let it run continuously for an hour. The voltage and current curves are horizontal and straight during the test without obvious fluctuations, so it's quite stable under long-term full load conditions. As the first PD 3.1 and GaN charger from Apple, it didn't continue the design of small size and lightweight like third-party brands. It also only supports PD protocol rather than adding support for PPS. But its charging performance is pretty good in terms of conversion efficiency, ripple, and especially in temperature. Okay, that's all for today's video. You can also click the corners to see its internal structure through our teardown video. If you like this video, please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. And I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye!